bird star, not with word, bird star is there, which is a DAS mode program. Now these words are being not known to the present generation. If I say word star means, what is word star, they will ask. And there will be a structure which is being typed in the dot matrix structure. Dot matrix structures will be there. That means, now this type of the phantom curriculum which is imposing the style of making the student, which can be accommodate earlier, which can be accommodate today, and which must be accommodate in future also. Those things has to be taken part. All these things has to be taken care in the case of a curriculum when it is being designed. So a part of the curriculum must be describing the past. A part must be there which is expressing the present. There must be a part which is providing us a value towards the future. Will all has to be provided for this curriculum, which is called a phantom curriculum. Next one is called the concomitant curriculum. Now here there is a context of religious expression, values, ethics, morals, practiced behaviors, social experiences, which are all based on, as said earlier, institutional instruction, teacher behavior, and also family preferences. This is most important one, the family preferences. Now we have to teach all these things to our students. That means the context of religious expressions must be there, because we adopt a particular religion. That religious experiences must be, should not be hidden or must be thrown away. Second, values must be taught. Ethics must be taught. Morals must be taught. If I am a great scientist who is producing a toxin which will give me more addiction towards a particular type of addiction, a drug, that means I am not a good scientist. If I am a great man who will do a physics work with the production of, you know pretty well the story of Alfred Nobel, he declared the Nobel Prize because he sold the dynamite to the England company at a very huge price. One day there was a news appear in the paper that both the Nobel has did. Then everybody has given a comment that a great demon has did, because he prepared the dynamite. Then only he feels it. Such a type of a greatest explosive what we found, that money should not be with us. So he produced a charity structure which gives Nobel Prize. Imagine, the moral which been taught to Nobel has produced a greatest prize. That means ethics, morals, and the values, best practices, all the social experiences must be taught based on the institutional instructions, teacher's preference, and also the family things. Because the family is a one which is a structure which is designing the student's life at many places. In future also, his life, the learner's life will be controlled by the family only. In such cases, these things are much more essential for doing this thing. Then next one is called the rhetorical curriculum. That means policy makers, institutional officials, university officials, administrators or politicians, they are giving certain ideas. And these ideas has to be incorporated because we are living under them only. So their policies, their structures must be also incorporated. That means a freedom struggle or an history man, when he is introducing that in India they have to give about a phenomena stating that Indian government is having a structure and that structure is being approved by so many world and all these things. Whereas a curriculum which is designed at Pakistan, say for an example, will not praise the other countries except Pakistan. A country like China will be praising more communalism because it practices it. In a country like USA will be more practicing capitalism because it is practicing the capitalism. So all these things are being incorporated into the curriculum because of these things are being offered by the policy makers, politicians, institutions, university officials, etc. So all if Madurai Kamaraj University is insisting something, the colleges which is behind will be has to follow it, because we do, when we do, we like it or not, we will follow it. Last year, what has been happened, majority of the autonomous colleges wanted to have an examination offline. But the government has said, it must be only through online. So we have to go with the online examination only. Such type of modification is called as the rhetorical curriculum, and this rhetorical curriculum will be based on the structures only. Next is called the internal curriculum. That means a curriculum which is present for each class or each course or for the each institution, which is called internal curriculum. That means, say for an example, our college is Vivekananda College, Thiruvedagam. This Thiruvedagam Vivekananda College is based, has been organized or been maintained by the Ramakrishna Tapovanam of Thiruparaiturai. They are having certain courses, and these courses like temple worship, then daily divine digest, all these things, yoga, then Sanskrit education, these things are being a general principle of the institution which we are being giving to them. That means one optional structure will be there, and that optional structure will be given to the student by the institution. Likewise, the type of fisheries college will be having a particular type of structures which is called ethics in fisheries. That means one should not have a particular type of net which should not be used. Why is that? Has been prepared throughout the world. Now they said it should not be used in the Indian waters, because Indian waters are having fishes which are having not a greater size, but the lean sizes only. So if you have this, the lean size of fishes, the larger fishes will be taken along with the small fishes, at one stage there cannot be no fish at all. Then in the case of agriculture also, the agriculture is being rotational basis, because our sands are not being conducive for the single type of crop system as like present in the case of USA and other things, because there is a temperature difference and everything is there. So it is only a rotational basis must be there, and that has to be followed also. And these things are called the internal curriculum. In case of Ooty, you can grow a tea forest for continuously more than 50 years or 40 years. Staines tea is one example. And that Staines tea which is being grown in Ooty is still surviving for more than 100 years. Whereas a particular type of places in near in our college is Solavandan, here they will be having a rotational. First time paddy, second time sugarcane, third time they will be having a maize. All these things are modified. They cannot continue it for a longer period. Even the coconut tree which is be thinking for a longer period will be cut off after 30 or 40 years, because it cannot give a good yield. Such type of modifications are being there for the internal structures. So we must be also having a curriculum based on a specific students. Say for an example, biology students, mean he will be having these structures. Chemistry students will have these structures. Physics students will have this type of curriculum. All these things are the basic things which we have to be incorporated based on the internal curriculum. The last one is the important, which we call it as electronic curriculum, and this type of electronic curriculum is based on the search in the internet, information, e-forms, e-communication and other things, which is called the electronic curriculum. Now the next thing is called in Indian school of curriculum, we know pretty well from the age of 2 to age of 26, everybody if he continuously studies from the play school to the postdoctoral DSc, DLit or super speciality studies can be done. And that means the school education will be there up to 16 years. From the school education it is going to be diverted. That means either going for a degree or for the education vocational programs like Polytechnic or IITs, ITIs, not IITs, ITIs, ITIs. Then from the UG education it will be running up to 20 or 21. Then it will go for PG. After PG it will for the PhD. Then from the PhD it will go for the postdoctoral. For people like engineering and medicine, the age will be up to the 21 or 22 for completing the UG. Then for Beijing, going for diploma or Beijing up to 22 or 23. Then general research curriculum or specialization they will go up to 26, age of 26 years they will be having. This is called the Indian School of Curriculum. Now, what are the materials which determines a curriculum? Now we know what is a curriculum, what are the types of curriculum, how at what age we have to study. In this basis, now we have to design a curriculum. Now determinants will be there. What are the determinants? Basic needs, social aspects, cultural factors, individual talents, ideals, intellectuals, moral, aesthetic, religious and traditional. These are the aspects for the determinants of curriculum. In which the stages of the determinants are, first we have to plan, pre-preparing, designing, developing, implementing, evaluating, revising and improving. All these things we have to do. In the curriculum planning, there must be philosophy, social forces, needs, goals and objectives, treatment and knowledge, human development, learning process and instruction and decisions must be there. So all these things must be there. Philosophy must be there. Social forces must be there. Needs of the structure must be there. Goals and objectives must be there. Treatment, knowledge, human development. Now this has to be given. Now the outcome based education or learner centered outcome for educational factors, LOCF, whether OBE or LOCF, both things must be having all these things in the curriculum planning. Now how to prepare? It is systematic systems, it must have data contents, it must have a selection, collection, assessment, then organization. All these things has to be looked at. That means first one is called systematics and systems. Second, data and content must be there. Third one, selection, collection, assessment. Then finally, organizing everything together is called the curriculum design. How can you design a factor? That means it must be school. Different levels and types and structures must be there. Then technology, education and technology, what we are going to use. Third one is called the systemic structures. Fourth one is called the vocational structure. Fourth one is called the social reconstruction structure. Generally, these type of things, after this, a curriculum design must be set up. In which, first we have to analyze the social needs. Next, we have to translate the needs into a course. Or in general, we have to translate learning terminal objectives has to be derived. A course objective must be there. A general objective must be there, a learning objective must be there, a terminal objective must be there. Then after that, splitting this objective into the specific objectives. First, general course objective must be there, it must be split into specific objectives. Then we have to collect all these specific objectives into group, finally make it as a group subjective objectives. This is called curriculum designing structure. That means I can example with our biology or zoology. Here one paper I am taking called invertebrata. That means animals without bone, backbone, which is called invertebrata. The worms, insects, will be coming under these categories. Snails will be coming under these categories. Now this type of invertebrata is a course which I am doing, in which I split into so many categories as a micro invertebrata, which is called protozoa, from which a smallest invertebrate will be there, which I call it as porifera and coelenterata, from which then I say that there are worms are there, Aschelminthes, Nemathelminthes and Annelida. Then insects are coming, which are being, now I can see where from a small to a larger insects, which will be flying or which will be crawling. Such type of insects are coming under arthropoda. Finally, animals, the invertebrata which lives in sea alone, which I call it as echinodermata. So, this type of categorization, and I am doing it as a first structural study, then different types of behavior, what is his mode of feeding, all these things are being I taught as specific objectives. Then finally pooled it as the evolution or the development of invertebrata at a different structure with a specific character. That specific character, with the specific character only, I can say it is being developing. So such type of things has to be developed. Then this, after this, deriving the subjects of the above classification, which should be enabling the objectives, then utilizing in every subject matter in a specific required time, finally the syllabus must be formulated. We know pretty well, I wanted to teach many things. I have said about many types of classification or subjectives which are special. Then I have to formulate a particular time through which I have to tell. University has given a clear time, UGC has given a clear time. A semester will have only 90 days. If my college is working for weekly 6 days, that means weekly 6 days means your college will work for only 15 weeks, not more than that. If my college is working for 5 days in a week, there will be 18 weeks only. So in the 6 months, generally 24 weeks will be there, in which 18 weeks we will be working. The remaining 6, we have to declare it as an examination or holiday or anything, assessment will be there. So in such cases, during the 6 months period, a particular type of time is being given to us. And that type, particular type of time has to be utilized by me for doing this, for the formation of the syllabus through which I am completing my invertebrata. Likewise, it is applicable to all subjects which has to be, syllabus has to be formed. Then various phases of curriculum for the development has to be taken. Instructional development, materials and media development, methods and teaching, testing has to be there. Before designing the curriculum, there must be instructional development must be there. What time we are going to do it. Materials and media must be given. Without that, we cannot conduct it. Then methods of teaching and testing has to be given. All these things has to be developed in the curriculum. After developing the curriculum, we have to take in consideration of all these things only. Now we are coming to the structure of a curriculum. A curriculum will have an introduction, scopes, aims and goals, course of study, and its allied structure as ancillary or something, methodology of teaching, material, media, evaluation scheme, outcome, world of work vista with the life. All these things must be present in the curriculum. From the introduction, then it has to pass to the scope. By studying this particular curriculum, what I am going to get it. There must be an aims and goals must be there. It must be a skill-based structure, means it is an entrepreneurial one. If it is a core subject, means it can be an analytical one or research-oriented one. Likewise, it means that to learn this subject, there must be an allied structure must be assisting us. Say for an example, if I want to learn thoroughly the zoology, philosophy, physiology, means I must know the biochemistry. Biochemistry must be known to us. That has to be there. Then materials has to be looked into that. Media used to be there. Then evaluation, how I am going to evaluate the student. Then what will be the outcome? Whether it will be useful for the life. All these things must be present in the structure of the curriculum. Then each unit has to be chosen with the first, we have to make the subject related matters as resources. There must be learning resource must be there. Second one, it must have appropriate strategies for the curricular transaction. Then it must be spent through the suitable medium in which the learning experience must be there. A progressive testing must be there of the achievement, and the objectives through these experience must be given. Now finally we are coming to the structure of a syllabus. The syllabus must be having general and specific objectives. There must be a content table must be there, that means unit number must be there. Next, it must have a relevant time for each teaching. Then knowledge, skill, aptitude, proportional materials must be there. It must have a knowledge for the Bloom's taxonomy of all the Bloom's taxonomy, basic taxonomy of knowledge, understanding, application, resources and other things must be applied. Must be applied in these structures. Testing references, testing must be there. References must be there in the syllabus, and this subject must be linked with the curriculum at the different levels. Moreover, another thing which has not given in my PPT is the e-learning structures must be also added, because recently the UGC has come out with the e-learning materials must be added. That has to be added. How to implement this one? There must be instructions. A complete instruction must be given. Then a plan lesson must be there. That means a pedagogy for each thing has to be given. Then transactional strategies from this subject to the subject, how the transactional strategies are to be coming, that has to be come up with this. Then appropriate media has to be used for this. Then classroom experiences must be promoted. There must be a continuous progress testing during the implementation of this curriculum. So at each level there must be a curriculum testing must be there, through which alone we will be. The important part of this curriculum is called the curriculum evaluation. First one is called the intra-curricular evaluation. That means in the school education we can see a person will be studying Tamil, English, social science, history, social science, science, maths, everything they will be studying. That means called an intra-curricular structure of education is implemented there. At the college level, it must be given in a specific structure of how you are utilizing or implementing the English language, where you are getting examples from the literature. Even a biology people will get it an example from the literature. There is no harm in it. That intra-curricular evaluation within our subjects must be there. Then teacher evaluation must be there. It must be a oral, it must be a test, it must be an assignment. Like that, a teacher evaluation must be there. Then student evaluation. Sir, this subject is very useful for us. This subject is totally waste for us. They can have their comments over it. We know pretty well in engineering, greatest modifications of the engineering subjects has come up only after the students' evaluation. Generally, there will be mechanical, civil, electrical engineering alone will be there. Now, there are n number of structure of engineering has been developed because this is only a contended structure. When I wanted to study an atomic engineering or a marine engineering, means I must have these things. From this student's evaluation, it has been developed. Then materials for evaluation must be there. Verification methods must be there. How to verify the student. Then evaluation test methods, how to evaluate it. Examination types must be there. It has to be there for the curriculum evaluation. Checking the outcome is an important structure. Just merely conducting an examination, evaluating, getting a mark or getting a grade will not be useful to that. Now we have to come out with the outcome. Whether the particular student is best in knowledge, best in understanding, best in applying, or best in all the three. That we have to revive it. If this thing has come, then we have to go for improvisation of the curriculum. That means we have implemented a particular subject. We are evaluating. When our outcomes are not so much greater, then we have to make our subjects more improved so that it will be affected with the system revision. A systematic revision must be done, or systematic self-revaluation must be done for the development of our curriculum. Now, an evaluation structure is there, and these evaluation structures generally having three types of activities. One is called outlining clear purpose, gathering the evidences, then judgment, and fourth part is an important one, which is called an evaluation is a part of the development must be shown. That has to be present in an evaluation. Right, in which what must be the approach for the evaluation? It must be a goal-based one. A particular goal has to be fixed. Say for an example, a physics student must know the basic principles of the physics. That must be at least known to him. An electrical engineer must be at least knowing the types of electrical structures which he can be employing with his future studies. That has to be known to him. All these goals has to be set. Then we must have a definite type of programs, educational programs must be there. Then next it may be goal-free structure. Say for an example, in the literature, a knowledge more to be gained over the subject. That alone in the literature. What is the purpose of the finally gaining more knowledge? If I know all the Tamil poems which is proposed by everybody, finally what it is going to say? I am having more knowledge on education. That's all. Rest of the things are not being useful for me. Such type of goal-free education can be also given to the students. Then it must have a specific electrical training programs must be there. Response must be there. Then what is intended for this curriculum must be also evaluated continuously. It must also having the decision making, accreditation format, then forming a professional judgment about the processes and other things has to be also given. Then the context evolution must be, the context evolution, finally we are coming to the context evolution. It must be having a basic kind of evolution like objectives, assessment need, diagnose the problem, methods like system analysis, survey, documentation, reviewing, hearing, all these things has to be there. The input evaluation must be also done. This must be having different type of capabilities and strategies. That is assessment system capabilities, alternative strategies, implementation strategies, budget, project, decision, selecting the sources, basis on this, judging the implementation must be also done. Now, what are the process of evolution? First thing is the procedural activities must be judged. Second one, methods must be monitored. It must be monitored, the process, designing and everything, whether it is implemented or not. Finally, we have to come for a decision. In this decision, what we are going to say, how to refine the program of the curriculum, how to control the process of the implementation of this curriculum, that we have to come out. And finally, a record for all these things, procedure must be there. Earlier we have done it, which is not so successful. Now we are implementing, we have to see the success. If not, we have to change it in some other manner. This is called the process of evolution. And what are the products of evolution? That means we have to come out with an outcome. And learner's outcome must be there. Whether the objectives have been related to the learner, whether the interpretation what they are giving is called worth or not, then operational measures criteria must be there. We have to come out with the stakeholders' judgment. The sort of, who are the stakeholders? Teacher, student, management, parents, and finally the society. All these five stakeholders must be come out with the judgment of decision, continue, terminate, modify, or refocus the present records effects. A decision has to come, continue, the subject or not, terminate the subject, modify the structure, refocus the structure. On the basis of the records, we have to come out with the as the product of evolution. So these are the different types of curriculum and the objectives of the curriculum, how to design a curriculum, how to make a syllabus, how to evaluate it, what are the basis of the evaluation. Finally, the outcome of the evaluation has been narrated for this session. I thank the authorities who has given me the opportunity. I thank the principal of the Palani College, the management of the Palani College, and also the authorities, especially Uma Madam, who has given me the opportunity for saying my knowledge regarding to the curriculum implementation and design. Hope it will be useful for you. I know that the important aspect of any college or any school or any university will be successful, more successful in designing and implementation of curriculum, because all these institutions are centered through a particular curriculum only, through which alone it can get or it can be uplifted at any level. With these few words, I thank the authorities who has given me the opportunity. Thank you so much.